Definitely. I think health-seeking behavior comes from a particular culture which is really, there has always been secrecy and silence about motherhood.
Mm.
These are practices which in the culture has been about keeping it indoors, keeping it private. So it's very difficult for that barrier to be crossed. But
right.
at the same time, when you're looking at community health workers and you're looking at ASHAs, I think that's the first step. Like Renu said, educating them through this kind of an awareness is to also engage with them and ask them for health-seeking behavior so that they come out into the open.
Hmm.
Now, for that public-private distinction needs to be really cleared. So you need to step out of the boundaries of the home and seek health. But seeking health, services has to be done through a certain kind of a engagement which has to be sustained. It has to be continuous through the education system, through the health workers who are there, through reinforcing those attitudes through the family members. I mean, health-seeking behavior, if you take a look, there is also a marriage between culture and commerce. You have another kind of health-seeking behavior where people are able to immediately access the kind of technologies which are available, like, new reproductive technologies to determine the sex of the fetus and then to terminate it if found to be female.
Hmm.
So if that has been done through a kind of a nexus between commerce and culture, why is it that the positive kind of, orientations are not taking place?
Right.
I think that is a question that we need to ask, because this is contradictory. You have the rural belt really going in for sex determination. There are mobile ultrasound vans going right down to the doorsteps of home. And you have sex selective abortion now becoming almost a universal phenomenon in India. So how come that has happened, whereas the positive kind of health-seeking behavior hasn't? So I think somewhere the kind of awareness that we are building needs to be stepped up through the media, through the community health workers. Even the government advertisements need to really relook at themselves in order to be able to put a gender perspective based on a rights, approach, based on an empowering and a, informed kind of understanding of this issue. So I think that would perhaps facilitate health-seeking behavior.
Right. So, Dr. Zuchi, would you have anything to add to that now?
Yeah, I think I agree with Mr. Said that we need to develop immediately, but whatever the funds have been allocated for the health sector, even those are not being utilized properly. So accountability has to be there. You have given us, say, particular amount A to one particular dispensary, then there should be an accountability. How have you spent it? Have you spent it? I mean, what was an expenditure? What was the, how much was allocated for, say, maternal services, maternity services? Were the drugs available to the women who are coming? So that is not there. So instead of doubling it immediately, which takes a lot of policy decisions and all that, so whatever we have given, right, now he's saying it has been, another two-thirds has been added to it. So there should be an accountability. So where has this money gone? Have you utilized it for the hospital, for the betterment of the hospital? The government doesn't refuse us to, tomorrow tell them that I want to buy an equipment, it may take some time, but it will definitely come. But it has to be used on the patient. There has to be auditing of those accounts. Like we have started auditing of maternal mortalities.
Right.
Our hospital is one of them. So similarly it should be. So I think that is,
I think that's
the first
a very pertinent point, the accountability at that level. So Mr. Huta, what would you say to that?
Efficiency of utilization, the velocity of money in the public sector, health, is very poor. And both the way it travels down and the accounts coming up, that has to be substantially speeded up. The sector lacks skill, it lacks HR skill, it lacks financial skill, it lacks, if I might say, training capacity, and everything is dependent on training. It lacks engineering and procurement logistic capacity. These 5-6 issues hold back. This is the housekeeping issues.
Right.
So doctors and nurses have to be given this support. And doctors and nurses cannot be wasted by being resources being too thin. Politically, we have done an architecturally imbalanced health system by opening too many institutions just for tokenistic purposes without ever analyzing what is needed to run them. It's now, how do you recoup a loss-making public sector undertaking into a profitable one? By first optimizing the existing resources. Then when you show efficiency, resource givers start giving resources. You may beat your breast about doubling, etc. But there is a very strong group, and rightly so, saying that so much money is lying unspent. So much money is getting wasted. So many doctors are absent. So many equipments have never been opened and used. Huta, what are you talking about, asking more money?
Right. So, Renu, I think Vijay Lakshmi mentioned something really important, the role of the media, you know, and the role of the government, especially the advertisements and all that we are talking about. Talking of the media, do you think that media, if you really compare, has really not done much as far as some kind of advertisements go? It is only, you know, the over-the-counter pills, which is the morning after pill, and only those kind of advertisements you keep seeing all over the TV channels. But the point is that what they really need to do, they are not doing.
I think, yes, I agree that I think the media can do a lot more. And, we have to start. And I think one other point I would like to say is that media must look at it, I think, as Vijay just pointed out. You know, she said, you know, this is a cross-cutting issue.
Yes.
And, it's not just about health. It's about water and sanitation. It's about, you know, even simple things like hand washing and water being available and healthcare workers. It's about the mother-in-law's role. It's about, so it's about the women in the families. It's how you're looking. How do you respect this little girl? And how does she grow up empowered and making her own decisions? So, and I think the media has a lot of role, right from the sops we see on the TV, you know, these days where women are portrayed in a particular manner and they're supposed to see. And I mean, it's so unfortunate.
Either only into, two kinds of women they show, you know, either the one who's absolutely subdued and the one who's always scheming.
Right.
You know, it seems as if, I'm sure if people from abroad would get to watch these serials, they would think, oh, India has only two kinds of women and nothing more. Well, getting back to the seriousness of the show, Vijay Lakshmi, again coming to you, I think now it's time for us to really look at some specific, you know, ways of dealing with these issues and how can some specific steps be taken. So what would you really come out with if I were to ask you this?
I think the first would be to look at institutional delivery in a larger sense of infrastructure, skilled health attendants, and scaling up the community health workers, and probably providing more incentives to the ASHAs. I think that would bring about a change, at least at the rural level. Then there's the urban health, which has been completely missed. I mean, it's not something that has been looked at till now. There's this huge urban clusters where women, marginalized women live. You have migrant workers, you have and then there's the tribal belt. So to look at the very marginalized, I think most of the resources that we have need to look at the least advantaged here. So that's the first that needs to be, that's a specific thing. The other thing would be then to look at education and then to see to it that it is done in a manner in which gender issues and gender sensitiveness is built into the curriculum, built into the way teachers are, you know, providing education, so that the girl grows up empowered, informed, and is ready to question and is ready to take care of herself. I think that's important. Then, of course, to implement the laws regarding child marriage and the rest of it. Then, of course, when it comes to the healthcare sector, finally to see the woman as separate from the body. I mean, the body is not just the woman. The woman is a larger entity, her autonomy, her agency. I mean, that is very important. A mother is not necessarily only a patient. So the larger issues of motherhood and the continuum of care, right down in Japan, there are certain programs where they followed it right down to the time when the child started going to school. So you have to look at large scale caring, right down to the time when women are no longer in the reproductive age. When you're looking at other issues related to women's health, I think then only the cycle would be completed.
Vijay Lakshmi, I'll have to really stop you here because now we are really running short of time. And at this point, I'd like to say thank you to all four of you for coming to the studios and for discussing this very important issue with me as well as with my viewers. Well, people, the stories of women who die during pregnancy, delivery or from postpartum complications largely remain untold. It would be startling to know that every fifth woman in the world dies of poor medical care available during childbirth. Though the situation is changing and India is trying to pull itself out of the bottom of the barrel, a lot needs to be done in this area. Poor women in rural India have largely been left behind by India's economic boom, which has lifted millions of people out of poverty. It is time that we started to take the health of our women a little more seriously. Only a healthy mother can nurture healthy babies and raise strong families. On that note, it's a wrap of today's Gender Discourse. I'll see you next week with another thought-provoking discussion on another gender issue. Till then, this is Lottie Alaric saying goodbye and take very good care of yourselves.